Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you all about the debut solo record from Biff Byford, Saxon's frontman, School of Hard Knocks, out February 21st on Silver Lining Music. The album has 11 tracks and is 51 minutes in length. To me, this is an album that cannot be defined by a single genre or by a category, really hard to do so, because it's very eclectic in its sound and in its lyrics. This allows him to really go to a lot of different places, pull out of a lot of different influences. Sounds and bands and genres that influence his career are really all at play, and they're all present into this record. Having said that, there are two common denominators that you're really going to find throughout the whole album, and to me, those two common denominators are really the glue that holds this record together. Because when you have an album that's this eclectic, it's really easy for the album to not have the right fluidity, for the tracks to feel very broken and individual, and for the album to lose its consistency and not feel as one. The first aspect is the overall sound. To me, there's definitely a style there, and that's old school British metal rock. You really feel listening to this album that you can place this album in a very specific geographic place. The second element plays off of that, and that is Biff's vocals. Very consistent all the way through. It doesn't matter the style, it doesn't matter the dynamic that the song has to offer. His vocals are always there, they're always on par, and they're extremely consistent and extremely well executed all the way throughout the album. The next aspect for me is definitely the lyrics. While the lyrics are volatile or eclectic, if you will, as much as the sound is, the lyrics play a huge role into this album. I really like the dynamic approach that they have. I like the fact that they tell stories, they talk about history, but they also talk about Biff's personal journeys and his own personal experiences. So you're going to get a little bit of two different worlds lyrically on this record, and to me that really plays well to the eclectic sound that the album has. So you have two strings pulling the album in two different directions, and then you have the overall sound in terms of the roots of that sound, and you have Biff's vocals as the two main ingredients that are holding everything together, not allowing those strings to completely pull the record apart. That is my take on this album when I look at the fluidity that it has, when I look at the structure that it has, when I look at the overall sound that it has. Another element of the record that I really appreciated was the fact that he included a couple of cover songs, and that to me added to the eclectic aspect that the album has. I really feel like it gave the album something different. It gave the album a little bit of a different feel, a different texture, and I really like his take on the covers, because it's not like he did two covers of two songs and he just stick to pretty much the original songs. He really created two new tracks. He gave his own personal twist, his own personal sound, his own personal DNA. So I really like that aspect. I really like that dynamic. And once again, it really proves how eclectic overall this album is. To me, the overall, I feel like the album is very interesting and enjoyable. I really enjoyed listening to it. It was an album that had a great playability. And if you're a fan of that specific style of metal rock coming out of Britain, this album really speaks to you because it has all of those elements. Some of them a lot older, some of them a lot newer, but I really feel like the base of this record, the main spinal cord of this record, is really a throwback one into the 80s and even 70s. It just has a lot of core elements that were really predominant in bands coming out of Britain during those two time periods. As far as songs are concerned, I picked three very different songs in order to illustrate how eclectic this album is. And I want to start with The Pit and The Pendulum. A song that, in my opinion, has a really somber sound to it. The vocals really add darkness, and the lyrics elevate that darkness into a whole new level. The chorus has great volume, and part of that is due to the fact of the layers to the vocal track. They added backing vocals in order to give the vocals a little bit more substance, make them a little bit more robust, and that really adds great volume to the chorus, making the chorus a lot more memorable. There's a middle acoustic bridge that really congregates the song, or merges the two parts of the song, the beginning and the end, and I really like the atmosphere that brought to the track. It really created an even more somber feel. It really brought the mood down, and the vocals during that acoustic bridge were dripped in emotion. You could really feel the emotion coming out of the vocals on the vocal delivery, and when you combine that kind of emotion on the vocal side with that acoustic sound, you really have a winning combination, and that bridge really merges the beginning of the track with the end of the track. So I really like what it did there, and it was a portion of the song that really drawn out all the darkness and somberness that the track had and brought it all into the light, if you will. Next, Scarborough Fair, one of those covers that I mentioned earlier, a Simon Garfunkel cover. This is an absolutely beautiful cover. One of my favorite songs on the record. I really like what they did here. Predominantly an acoustic guitar song with Biff's vocals obviously in there, and it really works well because it's really stripped down. It has a really interesting effect. It really allows the vocals to showcase themselves and to come into the forefront and dominate, be the driving force behind this track. Almost chilling at times. I really like the atmosphere that you get from the first portion of the song. That, like I said, a lot more acoustic. Overall, it feels like a very acoustic song, but the first portion of the song, definitely more acoustic. It gets a lot heavier towards the second stage of the song, specifically following the solo. The song becomes a lot more heavier. The guitars come in with a lot more power, a lot more pungence, and the song doesn't completely change dynamics, but it definitely gets a little bit heavier. So I really like how this song is structured, how this song is put together, and this is a magnificent cover. He really took a great original track, and he really created a track that is brand new, a track that is his now, that has his DNA, that has his sound, that has his fingerprint. My favorite, I'm just gonna say it, my favorite song on the record. I just love the darkness that it has. I love the mood that it has, but more so, I love the execution of the guitars and vocals on this track to really make it a magnificent track. And by the way, the solo is absolutely face-melting. I love the extended solo. I love how over the top it is, how much dynamic brings to the song, because the song is very mellow, very stripped down, and the solo really brings life into the song and really inserts life into that second half of the track. Absolutely magnificent. Last, Pedal to the Metal. As the name of the track indicates, this is a very straightforward, powerful, high tempo track. Really has a lot of that new wave of British heavy metal sound to it. Really high octane. The simplicity of the lyrics really work well with this track and really fits the genre, or at least the idea behind the song. So you have a song that has, it's very dynamic, very guitar driven, great vocals, really simple chorus, simple lyrics, and that makes the chorus really hooky, really catchy. Like I said, all the condiments of that new wave of British heavy metal sound that it was so popular back in the 80s, early 90s. Everything of that era is present into this song, making this one of the more memorable songs of the album. Absolutely earworm of a track, great dynamic, great fluidity, another great guitar solo, and that's something you're gonna get pretty much throughout the whole album, is great guitar solo after great guitar solo on these tracks. Really well played album as far as the guitars are concerned, not just from a solo perspective, but from the riffs and melodies as well. It's a really magnificent guitar played album. All right, guys, this is it for me. This is Biff Byford with School of Hard Knocks, a really interesting album, really dynamic, really eclectic, really showing different faces of him and what he can do, not only with his voice, but what he can do as a musician. Really interesting album, but I want to hear from you guys. What are your thoughts? Use the comment section below, let me know, and I'll be getting back to you guys. Take care.